Hey guys, it's Underpowered and welcome. This is the first episode of what I hope and what I promise is going to be an amazing Milan career mode. This probably, just to let you know, this probably will be a mainly career mode based channel, but I will, depending on the crowd that I attract, I will try to bring in other games and other forms of FIFA. But all of it really depends on you. Anybody who watches this, please just give me feedback and tell me how I can improve and anything that I can do to improve. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, I spent quite a bit of time thinking of this name. So please don't laugh at me as you see it. This is gonna be the world domination. We are gonna take over the world. We're gonna take European football by storm and put AC Milan straight right back where they were and right back where they deserve to be. They've had a very unfortunate last few years and they just haven't performed. They haven't been up to it, but I am determined to bring them back to their best. So seeing what the club want from us, they want us to finish in a round of 32 and they want us, well, just in the domestic cup, they want the round of 32, and they want us to win the league title. Great place to start. One of my first times playing on legendary, so this will be a very troublesome first season, but hopefully I'll be able to get great results and I'll be able to pull away in the league. Looking at the squad here, we have a pretty decent squad, but and I think anybody sitting watching at home will know this is going to be very difficult for me to win this league. This squad is very, how do I put it? They remind me of a squad that would probably barely qualify for the Champions League, but they do have players who can just set the world on light with the right person holding a controller, and I just hope that I'll be able to perform. We go into our sell players list. Oh, I'm sorry for the silence. We go into our sell players list and look at the squad and look at the loaned out players. And Fernando Torres, what a player! I can't wait for him to get back because I would love to use him. We recall Notarino from his loan because I think this squad is very thin. In terms of players that I will actually be comfortable in playing with, players like Sapanara, players like Montari, I won't be able to use them because I don't feel that they suit me as a player. But I don't know. If you guys think that there any suggestions about formations, about tactics, I'm welcome to anything. But okay, and also we recall Pel and Odomadi, my homeboy from Nigeria. What up, dog? And we place them straight on the transfer list later on because they won't be able to perform at any sort of level other than like in the first few rounds of the cup because we're going to be in those. But other than that, I just feel like they don't need to be at the club. And I don't know, but yeah, if you think different and you think that there'll be players to have as impact players, then let me know and just tell me in the comment section. But yeah, deleting a load of emails. One thing I really want to do in this is to try and keep my inbox clean, because if you see me in my personal career modes, my inbox is really messy, and I don't want that to happen here. Straight after recalling Notarino, we get a bid for him, and just looking at the chief executive comments, I was confused, but I thought, why not? And I asked them for 9 million in contrast to their 4.3 million, I think it was. So yeah, and advancing on past that, we see that they come back to us. Oh no, not yeah, we see that they come back to us. Say and. Apparently, transfer talks have broken down, unfortunately, and this is one of the things that really, really annoys me about career mode. When you have a really good deal set up, But other teams just don't want to be persistent and add 10,000 to the wage. Why? Just because they don't accept 80 grand, you don't have to just stop pursuing them at all. So yeah, that bid has fallen through, and yeah, we're back to square one basically. We have about 11 million, no one in specific that we can afford that we want, so yeah. But looking there, we see that Manchester United have sold Rooney for 55 million, and that's one thing. I want to know whether anybody that watches this, whether you prefer it to be a realistic career mode where we sign players that are actually linked to AC Milan or would fit into their real life style of play, or would you like it to be more personalized and to be more, I don't know how to spruced up and just like more freedom for me to do what I want and to take it in the direction that I want to. But yeah, we see Pazzini, Newcastle came in with 4.7 million, but we asked for 6 and they came back with 4.9 million, which wasn't much better than their first offer. But we accept it anyway, hoping to get a bit of extra funds, because Pazzini is a player that I haven't really enjoyed playing with ever. Like, playing the first few games on a pre-run of this, he just doesn't tickle my fancy. He just doesn't... he's just not nimble enough to play for me. But yeah. Yeah, we continued looking into our global transfer network, and seeing what has already been set for us, they pretty much are in line with the things that I would have been looking for, other than that free kick taker one, which is kind of interesting, but we'll see how that develops later on. But yeah, we set up an instruction and ask our scouts to look for a tall centre back who is worthy of playing in our first team that isn't older than 31, because I think in this game, and EA have done very well with that, I think when they get to about 32 or 33 is when they actually start to decline and drop in stats. So yeah, looking through the central defensive mids, we see Kadira, and this is going to be a problem until like the second or third season. We just can't afford him, and it's just going to be a real pain in the ass, because there are going to be a lot of players who would love to have. It's just that we won't have the funds to be able to get them. Like, McCarthy is a great all-rounded central defensive mid, just like Matic, but our budget just won't stretch for the first few seasons. Similarly, we look at Fernando, but just the same problem again. And it's gonna be recurring until we get into the Champions League and we do well and we get far. Also, we see Steven Gerrard and Seydou Keita, who are going for pretty cheap, but there might still be life in the old warhorse, but I don't really think that there'll be life enough in our squad. They do look they look pretty slow, let's just say it. But they look pretty slow and not really nimble enough. So yeah. We then go in to look at the strikers, seeing Ikechukwu Uche and seeing James Wilson, but I don't really think that they'll be good enough for the first team. The same for Sado Berahino, but we also see Eduardo Vargas and Sergio Aguero. Somebody else that we see in the list is Sergio Araujo, who I might have to get later on in the series, but I don't know. And I think one of the last players that we look at is Hernandez. Nope. Yeah, we also look at Muadika, who we sent an inquiry for, because I know he has a nice potential in the mid-70s, and he can grow to become a great impact player for us. But yeah, also we see Paulo Dybala, and this bloody man, he will grow, in any career mode that you do, he will always grow into the high 80s, and it's not a glitch, he's just amazing. We put in an inquiry for him, hopefully we can bring him into the club, we'll see. But we also see Luis Muriel, and we inquire about him as well, we're just looking to add in a little bit of pace and dribbling into our squad. Yeah. Seeing the inquiry for Morgan Schneiderlin, all smoke just been wafted away. That's not gonna happen. We don't have the money. And also seeing that they asked for 24 million for Dybala, that's not happening either. But yeah, this is gonna be the end of the episode. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.